what is the structure of mains examination. Now, here, first, two papers are there for mains. They are language paper. Obviously, we are slaves of Britishers. I'm personally purposefully saying we are, not where. Okay? The reason is that after freedom also, so-called freedom, I'm communicating with you in English language. What dress I'm wearing, that is also of English style. And what everything what we are following, that is of all Western, or rather than Western, I should say English style. And therefore, obviously, we must able to understand English language. I'm not saying there should be command on English language. If it is there, it's all right. But at least you should able to communicate in English language. And that's why the first paper we are saying that is of English. This is called as qualifying paper. So whatever the score is there, that is not considered in your score. But if you are not able to attend that score, that is qualifying level marks, then your other papers will not be checked. And so this language is important. So first thing that what I am telling, that is of English language, which is mandatory for all. The second language, that is Indian regional language. So here the change is there. Our Indianness is now coming out. And second language, that is of Indian regional language. So you can take English if you are belonging to Seven Sisters. But otherwise, you have to select any other Indian regional language. This is also for qualifying level. Again, so limit of qualifying level is changing according to the UPSC. Say for example, it was something 40% earlier days. Now it is reduced to 25%. So whatever the marks you have to obtain, that is out of 300, minimum 25% mark you must obtain. Then only you can be qualified. So two papers are there, that is qualifying level. And the biggest problem is that some students are preparing thoroughly for these papers. Say, it is not wrong, but these marks are not considered. So ultimately, if at all cutoff is there of 25 marks, then 25% mark, then you have to score 75 marks out of 300. So around that is sufficient. Don't waste too much of time in preparation of languages. But don't ignore that, because without qualifying, you are not able to move further. So if you are studying out, your education is there throughout in English medium, then nothing to worry about English. If you are from vernacular medium, then you have to give little bit more emphasis on English language. And any other regional language, so my suggestion is that you should take your mother tongue as your second language. So no much of the focus is required on that language, provided you must be thorough in your mother tongue. Because now in big cities, some problems are there that parents are communicating with their children in English only. And so many students are finding it difficult to communicate even in their mother tongue. There are students, those who are not able to write down in their mother tongue or read out in their mother tongue. So if that is the case, then you have to study hard, because both language you have to qualify. After that, the important paper is there, that is of essay writing. That is of 250 marks. Now, whatever the papers are there onwards, here, they are of 250 marks. So first paper I am talking, that is about essay writing. Now, why I am saying onwards? Because first two papers, language papers, they are not considered into counting. But here onwards, all marks are counted. Now, essay writing. In old syllabus, that is prior to 2012, they were having 300 mark essay writing paper. Then onwards they reduce it to 250 marks. But after some years, they changed out the strategy, and instead of writing one essay, they are asking you to write two different essays. So initially, Say, why I'm telling this? Because maybe possible all of a sudden they can change policy again. So initially, they were having consent that only one essay you have to write in around 2,500 words to 3,000 words in that. Now keep in mind, when I'm talking about essay, that is of 3,000 words, let us count that, assume that a single line is having 10 words. Assume it is not, but assume that single line is having 10 words. Then on single foolscape, say approximately 30 lines are there. So single foolscape will give you 300 words. So like that, you have to write down 10 foolscapes. Then that is approximately 3000 words. So again, you are aware that single line will never contain 10 words always. Maybe possible standard writing limit is of 8 words. So you have to write down more than 10 pages. So that much practice is required if only single essay is there. But in last few years, they changed the strategy. Instead of single essay, they are grouping up. Say essay writing is also important in this way, that initially they were having 4 subjects. Out of 4 subjects, you have to write down only 1 subject. Now they divided that and group A 4 subjects, group B 4 subjects. You have to select 1 subject from group A and 1 subject from group B, and you have to write down essay, obviously around 1200 words. And so writing task is somewhat reduced, because it is very easy to write down around 300 to 500 words for our generation. Say I am saying, my father or grandfather at that time, they were having habit of writing vast things. Say in those days, around 1980s, people were there watching out test match, if live telecast is there. Today we don't have time to watch entire test match. Even one day match is not observed entirely, but 2020. So like that, essay writing is also reduced. In syllabus, previously some 15 marks were reserved for essay. Then it came to 10. Now 7 marks for essay in some boards. So 7 mark and essay is not tallying up. So like that, our writing habit is reduced. And so we have to get more work on writing habit. Now how to write down essay? We have certain lectures here. You can follow that lecture where we are describing essay in detail. But right now I must tell you that clarity of thought is observed in essay. So you are having 3 minimum paragraphs, that is introduction, then description, and last is conclusion. So minimum 3 paragraphs are required. Okay, but as our essay is of 3000 words or 1200 words, 1250 words, it's obvious that you have to split up description para point wise. Say single point should be described in single paragraph, ideally speaking. Don't jumble out points here and there. Again, what new ideas you are giving in essay, that is important thing. So always, whatever the description is there, apart from that, what new ideas you are able to introduce in essay, that is giving you some more wattage. This essay is not only your testing of language, but it is something like mapping your personality, that how you are thinking over some topic, how clearly you are able to put forward the points, argumentation, and then you admire the reader to accept your view. This is actually skill. And like that, a point-wise description is important. I may suggest you here a book written by great freedom fighter V.T. Savarkar, that is 6 Glorious Epoch in Indian History. I'm revising name of book, 6 Glorious Epoch in Indian History. This is available on website www.savarkarsmarak.com for free of cost. So here, my recommendation is that you can read out this book. Ideally, how thoughts are put forward and how new ideas are entered in that particular way, it is fit inside that. This is fantastic example of the argumentation style. So you can go through this book. You will realize that the other authors are writing about Indian history, and what V.D. Savarkar is writing about Indian history, they are totally different. But the way of argumentation is very, very nice. You can check out. So like that, you have to give new ideas. You have to put down the point in such a way that ultimately reader admires, yes, what you are saying is really a truth. So like that, you have to put forward your points, and you have to complete the essay. Keep in mind, completion of essay is really essential. Other things, obviously, the grammatical purity of your language, then vocabulary, then the way you are writing, particularly your handwriting, and all these things obviously matters. So this is about something essay writing, 250 marks. Then four papers are there, they are of GS paper. Okay, each paper is of 250 mark. So like that, you have to go for four papers of essay. Then the most important thing, that is optional paper. So 500 marks optional subject paper is there. Each paper, optional subject is also divided into two papers, paper 1 and paper 2, but only one subject is there. Say for example, if you are taking history, then paper 1 will be of history only and paper 2 will be of history only. 250 marks each paper. So like that, 500 marks there are for history, for optional subject. You can count it, 250 into 4000, 250 marks for essay. And 250 marks, 500 marks for general study, for optional. Total 750 marks are there for mains. Language just for qualifying purpose. And therefore, you'll realize that whatever the 1750 marks, 1750 marks, that is considered as your main score. Out of that, whatever the main score is there, that cutoff they are setting out, and only those who are above cutoff, they are called for personality test.